The ACME collaboration presents the electric dipole moment of the electron. Why is the universe made up of matter? Why is most of that matter mysteriously invisible? These are just a few of the fundamental questions that the ACME experiment is trying to answer by studying one humble particle, the electron. The most successful theory of particle physics is called the Standard Model. It says that everything is made up of a small collection of basic particles, and it tells us how they interact with one another. This theory explains everything from electricity to the existence of the Higgs boson, and it does so extremely accurately. But the universe still holds mysteries that we think the Standard Model cannot solve. One of these mysteries starts at the Big Bang, when, according to Einstein's formula, E equals mc squared, a giant flash of energy was transformed into objects that have mass. In the Standard Model, this transformation of energy requires that for every particle created, a partner antiparticle was also created. If a particle and its antiparticle encounter each other, they annihilate and convert back into pure energy. The strange thing is that the universe we see now is almost completely made of particles rather than antiparticles. Yet the Standard Model doesn't explain how there came to be more matter than antimatter in the time from the Big Bang to now. Another big problem is that most of the stuff in the universe is made of particles that are not part of the Standard Model. Astronomers know that there is hidden dark matter that we can't see with our telescopes, but whose gravity affects the ordinary matter that we can see and understand. Some clever physicists have come up with possible solutions to these problems, and other ones. Most of their theories include a zoo of exotic new particles which have yet to be discovered. Some of these new particles could account for the matter that we can't see, or could interact in such a way that would result in all antimatter getting destroyed, while some matter survived. At particle accelerators like the Large Hadron Collider, physicists are trying to create these new particles by violently smashing protons together. From sufficient energy, new particles can be created, just as in the Big Bang. This is how most of the types of particles that we know about were discovered, and we hope to find some of the new predicted particles in this way. The ACME collaboration is looking for new particles in a very different way, by making a precise measurement of a familiar particle, the electron. We are trying to measure the electron's electric dipole moment, which is the distance between the electron's center of mass and its center of charge. The electron acts as an antenna, sensitive to the presence of the weird quantum mess of particles surrounding it all the time. Some of the exotic new particles that theorists predict should give the electron a dipole moment large enough for an extremely precise experiment to measure, but still astonishingly tiny. Our experiment is sensitive to a dipole length of 1/10 of a billionth of a billionth of a billionth of a centimeter. To understand just how small this is, imagine blowing the electron up to the size of the solar system. The displacement our experiment is sensitive to would be the same as the diameter of a needle. To look for this dipole moment, we use molecules called thorium monoxide. The highly charged thorium nucleus acts as a hugely powerful amplifier for the signal from a dipole moment of an electron in the molecule, and the presence of the oxygen acts as the volume knob, which we can turn up to maximum by turning on an electric field in our lab and aligning the molecules. Thorium monoxide has the biggest amplification of any known molecule. It increases our signal size by a factor of 1 billion. Through careful use of lasers, we can watch how the electrons within these molecules behave as they pass through our experiment. Because this effect is so tiny, we have spent months carefully looking at the data and double-checking our work to make sure we are looking at the signal due to the electron's dipole moment, if there is one big enough to see, rather than some other spurious effect. Our measurement was about 10 times more sensitive than previous measurements, and we still think the electron has no electric dipole moment. This suggests that some of our favorite new particle theories might be in trouble. But the jury is still out, and we are going to keep looking.